Mr. Secretary, it is a pleasure to welcome you here in Jerusalem. I know that it is not your first visit to Israel and to Jerusalem, but this is your first visit as Secretary of State. I would like to thank, in the name of all the people of Israel, to President Biden, to the administration, and to you yourself for the solid support of your people, you people in Israel. Israel have no greater ally than the United States. You are our greatest friend. And I must say that the friendship is being really expressed in bipartisan relationship between the people of Israel and the people of the United States. We know that this is a really strong ally, and this is something that brings us a lot of confidence when we know that we have such good friends. And really, we welcome you. The bipartisan is could be expressed also from time to time from the ability of both of us not to agree. And friendship means to agree, not to agree. So I welcome you, and we have a great pleasure and honor. We will discuss afterwards the position and the problems of the region, the problems with Iran, the problems of our need to find a way in order to discuss and to find once and for all a sort of understanding and building confidence between us and the Palestinians. We know that fundamentalism, anti-Semitism, hatred, racism is something that goes against the whole humanity, and I'm sure that you will stand along with us to stop anti-Semitism when we are talking about the phenomena that we are watching just now in America and in Europe, and what is going on once we are using fundamentalism, Islamic fundamentalism, when Israel and the Jewish people have no war with Islam whatsoever. Mr. Acting Ambassador, it is a pleasure to have you with the Secretary. Mr. Secretary, please.
Well, Mr. President, thank you very, very much. And as you know, President Biden asked me to come to Israel this week in particular, to underscore the commitment of the United States to our partnership, to our alliance, to Israel's security, and to the work that we need to do together to continue to try to bring peace, bring communities together. And deal with some of the challenges that you so eloquently alluded to. And I would just say, Mr. President, it's particularly an honor for me to be with you today because of your own remarkable leadership and statesmanship in bringing communities together, and also in being such a powerful voice around the world for Israel's story, and also a voice against anti-Semitism, and warning the world what this means when we see eruptions of anti-Semitism, as we saw just recently in my own country, in the United States, incidents that President Biden immediately denounced as despicable, that we stand strongly against. We know that when we see the emergence or reemergence of anti-Semitic incidents, it's, as we might say, sometimes a canary in a coal mine, because it almost always suggests that more will come, more will follow, directed against other communities as well. So there's a lot of work to be done, of course, here in trying to advance the cause of peace and reconciliation. And there's work to be done around the world. And we're very grateful that your voice is such a strong one in these efforts. So it's a pleasure to be with you today. Thank you.
Thank you so very much.